In his youth, British statesman Winston Churchill had fought as an army officer in the Anglo-Egyptian campaign in the Sudan against the Islamist jihadist Mahdi army of Muhammad Ahmed ibn Abdullah, who had proclaimed himself the Mahdi of Islam, the guided one, and called for jihad to establish a pan-Islamic state. But not only had Churchill fought alongside Muslim soldiers against Islamist fanatics, he also studied Islam so deeply, with such interest, that for a time his family feared that he might convert to Islam. In his book about these experiences, this is what Churchill wrote about Islam and Muslims.
"How dreadful are the curses which Mohammedanism lays on its votaries. Besides the fanatical frenzy, which is as dangerous in a man as hydrophobia in a dog, there is this fearful fatalistic apathy. The effects are apparent in many countries: improvident habits, slovenly systems of agriculture, sluggish methods of commerce, and insecurity of property exist wherever the followers of the Prophet rule or live. A degraded sensualism deprives this life of its grace and refinement, the next of its dignity and sanctity. The fact that in Mohammedan law every woman must belong to some man as his absolute property, either as a child, a wife, or a concubine, must delay the final extinction of slavery until the faith of Islam has ceased to be a great power among men. Individual Muslims may show splendid qualities. Thousands become brave and loyal soldiers of the faith. All know how to die. But the influence of the religion paralyzes the social development of those who follow it. No stronger retrograde force exists in the world. Mohammedanism is a militant and proselytizing faith, and were it not that Christianity is sheltered in the strong arms of science, the science against which it had vainly struggled, the civilization of modern Europe might fall as fell the civilization of ancient Rome."